Hi, in this video we will demonstrate a couple of tools that we recently developed for SFO. They mainly deal with coordinate extraction and parameter mapping, so it's kind of like a data management workflow, which is very interesting, applicable to a lot of different scenarios. So let me show you just briefly. A lot of disciplines, actually, at some point in time, you need to extract the coordinates of your elements from the model. So that's why we created like a very simple command that can extract internal coordinates from internal coordinate system or shared coordinate system. You can, as a user, check whichever you want. And you get a list of categories, point-based categories, in this case, to extract coordinates and apply to instance level on the shared parameters with predefined name and, you know, attributes. So you have find like, a, for example, search option and so on. But in this case, let's extract coordinates for all of these elements. Click apply and you see the progress bar tracking progress of data extraction and applying to parameters on an instance level. As you can see, coordinate extraction is completed and now plugin will apply values to the model and let's inspect results. So, okay, completed. If we select one element, now we will see that we have XYZ coordinates, and it's also extracted the unique identifier, or commonly known in Revit API as a GYD, which is a unique value that represents this element and supposed to not be duplicated, right? Uniqueness. XYZ coordinates of internal coordinate system, but we can also apply the shared coordinate system. And that is it for this coordinate extraction. So mainly point-based families, and because you are in modeless dialogue, you can interact with model, run again, and then see inspect results. Okay, let's go to parameter mapping. It is a very interesting functionality or a tool, and even the workflow. Why? Because let's suppose, for example, this element. Sometimes you need to transfer values from one parameter to another, regardless of it's on a type level or an instance level. Okay, so what tool does, it checks existence of these parameters that start with SFO and determines if they are on instance or type level, so we can establish the mapping. What it means, for example, this selected element here, we have a coefficient of utilization parameter, but we also have SFO underscore coefficient. They are all on the instance level, so it means that if we click this set parameter, we can target coefficient of utilization. We can click apply and we establish the mapping. Data from this one will go to this parameter when we click apply. How do we do that? We select the checkbox which we want, because in some cases you can have like a very large number of parameters and values that you want to transfer. And simple like click apply, it will go through all the elements of these categories on which this parameter is applied and extract values from this one and paste here. So it's kind of very advanced copy-pasting exercise, right? So you can see now a coefficient of utilization is 0.6 something and SFO coefficient is 0.6 something. So idea is this process of mapping you do once and then you save the mapping. How do you save mapping? Well, you click here and save the mapping. Before I already saved the mapping, I will load one configuration just to show you. And what we can do, we can sort the values, we can inspect them, okay? And what we can do for all of these, we can click checkbox, click apply. And easy like that, we are transferring values from all the elements that have the system classification to the SFO system. And one by one, we are extracting, applying to other parameters. Okay, values are extracted. For example, this one, you see same scenario. It is copied here. And for example, speak this one, you see SFO mark is 947, for example, but here, if you go to mark parameter is 947 and so on. So it means that you can transfer from one parameter values to another and apply to the model. Thank you. You hope you find this workflow very useful, very interesting. We enjoy developing this tool and thanks SFO for providing us ability to share the outcome of the collaboration. Thank you